better days ahead of you. They believe that God is working on your behalf. Regardless of what's going on right now, they believe. Listen, you need more balcony people in your life. You need to surround yourself with people that are going to speak words of faith over you. Get the doubters, get the critics, get the naysayers, get the pessimists. Get them out of your life. Get the basement people out. And get some balcony people. Let them speak into your life. So listen to the right people. Now, number three, you've got to get to the right place. Get to the right place. Go back to our text in verse number 5. The Bible said the king of Syria said, Go and I'll send a letter to the king of Israel. So he departed, took with him 10 talents of silver, 6,000 pieces of gold, 10 changes of raiment. And he brought the letter to the king of Israel. And he said, Now, when this letter has come to you, behold, I therewith have sent Naaman my servant to you so that you can recover him from his leprosy. Now, first of all, you have to understand, Israel is a conquered nation. So to Naaman, Israel is a second rate, kind of like a third world country. It had absolutely nothing to offer him. Syria is the prestige nation. Israel is like a third world country. It would not have been a place that he would have chosen to receive his miracle. But you see, get this, God had to get Naaman out of Syria because God wanted to get Syria out of Naaman. God wanted to get Naaman out of Syria because he knew that he had to get Syria out of Naaman. Because Syria was where Naaman had power. Syria was where Naaman had position. This is where Naaman was somebody. And as long as Naaman remained in Syria, he would cling to that power. He would cling to that position. He would cling to the fact that he was somebody special. And he would never be able to humble himself into the position where God could touch him. You see, as long as he was clinging to what Syria represented, he would never be in the place where God could heal him. You see, I really believe that God is speaking to someone right now. As long as you remain in the current position you are in life, you are never going to be healed. There are some things, there are some people that you are clinging to in life that, quite frankly, they're the root cause of your pain. But you won't let them go. You cling to them because they are your safety net. They are the ones on whom you have depended all of your life, and you're afraid to let go. You're afraid to release it because that's all that you've ever known. But you see, God is wanting you to get out of Syria. He's wanting you to move away, maybe not physically, but emotionally with some things so that he can get Syria out of you. He's moving you away from everything that you're clinging to as your security blanket so that you can be in a position where you have to trust God. You see, I'm sure Naaman, he could have easily thought, oh, I can't, prophet can just come here. Why do I have to go to Israel? And I know you may be thinking, well, why can't God just heal me in this position? Why can't he just do it right now? And he absolutely can, but the problem is, until you change your position, you will still be surrounded by the very things that are causing you pain. You're going to go right back to the same habits, the same position of hurt, that got you here in the first place. You've got to get up. You've got to get out of Syria. Be willing to go someplace in life that you have never gone. Because where you are is hindering your healing. And I feel like, again, that is a prophetic word for you. Where you are right now is hindering your healing. Now, look at Naaman. He goes to the right place, but he goes to the wrong person. Look in verse 6 of our text. The Bible says that he brought the letter of the king of Syria. He brought it to the king of Israel saying, Now, when this letter has come to you, behold, I've sent Naaman my servant that you can recover him from his leprosy. And it came to pass, the king of Israel, he read the letter, he rent his clothes. He said, Am I God to kill and to make alive that this man sends unto me to recover a man of this leprosy? You see, the king, he's got political power, but he doesn't have spiritual power. The king knows all the right words to say politically, but he doesn't have the word to spiritually deliver and bring healing to this man. Listen, there's some people, They may be in the right place, but they're lacking the power that are needed to pray over you and to bring healing into your life. There's some people in the house of God, they know the right things to say. Politically, they've got everything together. They speak smooth words, suave words. It sounds great. They know the sound bites. They know the religious platitudes, but they don't have the power and the anointed that are needed to bring healing into your life. You know, I've said it often. I'm going to say it again. Be careful who prays over you. Be careful who lays hands on you. Because just because they have the political correctness doesn't mean that they have the spiritual power that is needed to pray over you. I want you to understand something. We've seen people healed. We've seen people delivered. We have seen people filled with the Holy Spirit, giving their heart to Jesus after many people have already walked out the door simply because we've got people that know how to pray. And the position you're in right now, you don't need some cutesy little politically correct prayer. You need somebody that is full of the Holy Spirit, full of power. Somebody to pray over you, willing to take spiritual authority over what you need healing from. The fourth principle is this. You've got to follow the right prescription. Look in verse 9 of our text. Naaman came, the Bible said, with his horses and his chariot, stood at the door of the house of Elisha. And Elisha sent a messenger to him and said, go wash in Jordan 7 times and your flesh is going to come again to you and be thou clean. But Naaman was angry. He went away and said, behold, I thought, surely he's going to come out and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God, strike his hand over the place and recover the leper. You see, in Naaman's eyes, as if going to Israel was not bad enough, now the king sends him to Elisha. Elisha lives in Samaria. Samaria is like the armpit of this third world country of Israel. Samaria is the worst place to go. Even the Jews of Israel hated the Samaritans because they were half-breeds. They were outcasts. But yet God sends him to Samaria. He sends him to this small area. Listen to me. God many times may lead you to do something and go somewhere that you don't think is worthy of you going. He may ask you to do some things that in the flesh, in the mindset of the human, may be below. Some people, they want the big show. They want the prophet to come out and make a big show, lay hands on. But listen, God may be able to heal you. He is wanting you to not look for the show. He's wanting you to obey and do what God wants you to do. Listen, he told Naaman. He said, you've got to go down into the River Jordan 7 times. 7 is the number of completeness. It is a divine number. 4 isn't enough. 5 isn't enough. 6 isn't enough. It's got to be 7 times in order for you to be healed. Listen to me, my friend. Your healing is right here. I want you to know your healing is complete. Your healing is done. Your healing is achieved and accomplished by the Lord Jesus Christ. Today, reach down. Accept it. Walk this path of healing. It's God's will for you.